Nah, he's not gonna do it. He's saying someone won't do it.
When the up-and-coming rapper Juice WRLD, whose birth name is Jared Anthony Higgins, died in December of 2019, he left behind many devastated fans. People felt that his career had just begun and he had died too soon. Recently, social media users have been looking into the details of Juice WRLD's death, and some people even believe that his death was faked, or at least not exactly what it seems. Even if you're a skeptic, just wait until you hear this mind-blowing evidence before you fully make up your mind. Keep watching till the end of this video to hear exclusive details that may reveal that Juice WRLD is not really dead. Interact with us. Subscribe and hit the notification button to be notified when we upload more content. Don't forget to leave a like and comment below. Also, feel free to suggest any type of videos you would like to see on this channel. Thanks! If you didn't already know, Juice WRLD, an iconic mainstream rapper from Chicago, was born on December 2nd, 1998. From the age of 4, he enjoyed playing music, including the piano, guitar, and drums. In his sophomore year of high school, he began making his own music and posting it to SoundCloud. Unfortunately, when he was in middle school, he also got into abusing prescription drugs and smoking cigarettes. Years later, Juice WRLD was rocketed into fame in 2018 when his song Lucid Dreams went viral on the app TikTok, with thousands of people making videos to his song. His debut studio album from 2018 called Goodbye and Good Riddance was certified platinum by the Recording Industry Association of America. All 5 of the singles from his first album charted on the Billboard Hot 100. He released his second studio album titled Death Race for Love in 2019. Now that you know a little about Juice WRLD's journey to fame in the music industry, let's have a refresher on Juice WRLD's death. Juice WRLD died on December 8, 2019, while waiting in a private hangar at Midway Airport just after landing in Chicago. He died just 6 days after his 21st birthday. The plane had been apprehended by law enforcement officers immediately after landing because of suspected illegal drugs on board. They ended up finding 3 handguns and 70 pounds of weed on the airplane. Juice WRLD had allegedly swallowed some pills to hide them from the officers. According to his girlfriend who was there with him, Juice let out a gasp and collapsed to the ground. He was administered Narcan, an emergency treatment for opioid overdose, taken to the hospital, and even given CPR and more Narcan on the ambulance ride, but that did not prevent his eventual death. He was first taken to Holy Cross Hospital and was then transferred to Advocate Christ Hospital, where he was pronounced dead at 3:14 a.m. The toxicology reports released by the Cook County Medical Examiner revealed that his death was caused by accidental overdose on oxycodone and codeine. Other drugs found in his system included THC, morphine, and caffeine. However, some people find the details of Juice WRLD's death to be fishy and have done some investigating to see if that's really what went down. One of the biggest pieces of evidence that believers in Juice WRLD's fake death have is a tweet that the rapper made in 2017. The tweet reads, "My goal is to get overly famous, shine for a couple years, then fake my death." Juice WRLD has alluded to his own death in his songs as well. For example, in the song Legends, he says, "What's the 27 Club? We ain't making it past 21. Eerily, Juice WRLD ended up dying at 21. People have also pointed out a line in his song, "All Girls Are the Same," which says, "I'm a jealous boy, really feel like John Lennon." Both Juice WRLD and John Lennon died on December 8th, which is a strange and unlikely a coincidence. While these pieces of information are weird and morbid, they can be easy to dismiss. An ex-girlfriend of Juice told sources that he did drugs to try and self-medicate because of his depression. People with depression can often have many thoughts about death, which may explain his many tweets and lyrics about the subject. Another strange coincidence that was pointed out is that Juice WRLD died shortly after having a drug overdose-induced seizure, and not too long before he died, it became a trend on TikTok for people to imitate having a seizure to one of Juice WRLD's songs. Some people think that maybe maybe this trend manifested the death of Juice WRLD or caused him to have a seizure somehow. Another hint that people found was hidden in the new album from the artist Clever, who worked closely with Juice before his death. The first letters of each song in the track list of Clever's album, that's set to come out in 2021, spells out the message, Juice WRLD is alive. Does Clever know something that we don't? Or is he just stirring the pot? A hidden message in an album, or an internet trend, isn't very concrete proof that Juice WRLD is still alive, but the evidence that he may have faked his death gets even crazier. People on the internet have been diving deep into the case of Juice WRLD's death and have been sharing their findings on their suspicions about his death. Some TikTok users have utilized a flight tracker to find where Juice WRLD was on the day of his death. They claim that Juice WRLD's favorite private jet, which he allegedly took to Chicago on the day that he died, never ended up in Chicago, but went to the Bahamas instead. This was a major red flag because for many years, people believed that Tupac Shakur and other famous rappers and celebrities that might have faked their death are living in Cuba. Some people think that Juice WRLD planned to fake his death, took his plane to the Bahamas, then took another plane to Cuba, where he is living with other famous people that faked their death. Another TikTok user even claims to have called the hospital that Juice died at, Advocate Christ Hospital in Chicago, and found that there was no record of Jared Anthony Higgins being admitted or dying on the day of his death. He even posted a video of himself making the phone call to the hospital. It is possible that the receptionist that this TikToker spoke to misspelled Jared's name, as it is an uncommon spelling and the video does not show the spelling being confirmed. But if this is true, it is certainly the most compelling piece of evidence. The person that made the video reminded his viewers that when rapper XXXTentacion died, many people called the hospital to confirm that he had died and they all got positive responses. Conspiracies surrounding Juice WRLD's death have also exploded on Reddit. Some people on Reddit thought that Juice's death was linked to the occult, citing the visuals in the music video for his song Lean With Me, which includes footage of Juice in a church with a strange old woman. They also pointed to strange videos from his Instagram story in which Juice appears to be trying to sell his soul. Another Reddit user thought that record companies are faking the deaths of artists to get a surge in sales because of artists' popularity rising after their deaths. Then the supposedly deceased artists are given a new identity. There were also many people on Reddit who thought that the Illuminati could be behind Juice WRLD's fake death. Overall, many people found Juice WRLD's death to be sketchy, but most people couldn't come to a conclusion about what exactly happened. While there seems to be evidence that Juice WRLD may still be alive, there is also hard to deny evidence that he really is dead. For example, there were many law enforcement officers, healthcare workers, and airport staff who witnessed Juice WRLD having his fatal seizure and they filed reports about it. Juice WRLD's body was also examined by the Cook County Medical Examiner's Office, which is how it was possible to determine that an overdose of oxycodone and codeine is what killed him. People might dismiss this as the government covering up for his fake death, but there were also some of Juice WRLD's friends on the plane, and DJ Academics even shared a video of Juice on the plane several hours before he died, and the location was tagged as Chicago. So what do you think? Did Juice WRLD really die, or is he still alive somewhere? Is there some organization that is behind his fake death? There certainly is compelling evidence for either side of the argument. Let us know your thoughts about Juice WRLD's death in the comment section below.